Welcome to an animation on inverse functions. The goal of this video is to illustrate why a function has to be one-to-one to have an inverse function. Remember, to determine if a function is one-to-one, we perform what's called a horizontal line test. If a horizontal line intersects the graph in more than one point, it's not a one-to-one function. So here we have four functions. This first function is not one-to-one because these horizontal lines intersect the graph in more than one point. And for the same reason, this graph here is also not one-to-one because these horizontal lines intersect the graph, again, in more than one point. These two on the right, though, are one-to-one because horizontal lines never intersect the graphs in more than one point. So these are both one-to-one. Remember, what that means is that these two functions have inverse functions and these two do not have inverse functions. A couple things we must remember. A function must be one-to-one in order to have an inverse function. And then also, a function and its inverse is a reflection across the line y equals x. Let's take a graphical approach to this. What we're seeing here is a solid curve of the original function. Now it's broken up into two different colors. The green part for the left side, the red part for the middle, and the right side is also solid green. Then it's reflected across the line y equals x, and the reflection is the dashed curve. So what we should notice right away is that the solid curve and the dashed curve are reflections across the line y equals x. Now if we take a look at only the solid curve, notice that it does fail the horizontal line test. Therefore, it is not a one-to-one function. And again, what that means is that the inverse will not be an inverse function. And we can see that pretty clearly now, too. If you take a look at just the dashed curve, this would fail the vertical line test, and therefore would not be a function. But what we can do now is manipulate the original function so that it's a one-to-one function, or passes the horizontal line test, by moving this point up and then moving this point up as well. And notice that as soon as the red piece disappears, the function will then be one-to-one, as we see here. So again, the solid curve is the original function, which now would pass the horizontal line test. Therefore, it's a one-to-one function, which has an inverse function, which we see here in the dashed curve, which again we can see would pass the vertical line test. So if the original function is not one-to-one, the inverse will not be an inverse function. Let's show that again. If the original curve is not one-to-one because it fails the horizontal line test, because a horizontal line would now intersect this graph in three points. So the resulting inverse would fail the vertical line test, as we see here. So I hope you found this illustration helpful. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.